Everybody thinks we're wrong. Who are they to judge us?
Mother.
Simply calls me where I am. Mother.
And welcome to Mr. Landry's English class. We're talking about grammar, the words we choose in our sentences, the words that we choose in our sentences that make all the difference. What are the words that we choose? We're going to be talking about adverbs. Adverbs describe the how, where, and when of action, and they modify adverbs, adjectives, and verbs. So we're going to take a quiz today, two of them actually. Our expectations for this class are to complete two worksheets, 5A and 5B. 5A and 5B, being able to identify adverbs. The objective for today's class is to assess whether students are able to identify adverbs used correctly in a sentence as part of grammar and parts of speech. So we will not delay as we move quickly into our first worksheet. It is a quiz on identifying verbs. Cottage staff, everyone should have something to write with and write on. You do not need the worksheet 5A, but it is good to have as it makes everything much easier. Loose leaf paper is fine. Loose leaf paper and something to write with. Quiet place where you can sit and not be distracted or distract anyone. That is most important. And our first worksheet 5A quiz looks like what you see here. We'll review the directions now. Find the adverb. How do we find the adverb? An adverb is a word that modifies a verb. It describes how, when, or where an action happens. For instance, read the sentences below. In each sentence, the verb is underlined. Circle the adverb that describes the verb. So we're circling the adverb that describes a verb. Circle the adverb that describes the verb on the line to the right. So you will write your answers right here. Write whether the adverb describes how, when, or where the action happens. So you should write how, where, or when the action happens. So you're circling the adverb and then writing how, when, or where the action happens. Two parts to each sentence. There are 15. We will take 10 minutes for quiz 5A. Find the adverb. You should be seated quietly. You should have something to write on and write with. Something to write on, write with. Please begin now. Thank you. You may pause or stop the video at any time. You may pause or stop the video at any time. This is work time on quiz 5A. We're working on quiz 5A, answering questions 1 through 15. Circle the adverb and write on the line whether it describes how, when, or where the action happens. We'll take another 4 minutes, 5 minutes. We'll take about another two minutes on quiz 5A. Please write clearly. Please make sure your name is on your sheet with the date and your cottage name. Please write clearly your name and the date. We'll take another 2 minutes. Thank you. And you should be wrapping up your answers for 5A, 1 through 15, finding adverbs, circle the adverb, and writing on the line the how, when, or where the action happens. How does it happen? Where does it happen? When does it happen? What is the adverb describing? Wrapping up your answers now, but another 30 seconds or so. And please make sure that your name is on your sheet. Very important, your name is on the sheet and the date. Preferably your quiz should have your cottage name as well, because I give credit to your cottage for the work that you're doing as part of the competition. And we're going to start with number one. Again, we're going to circle an adverb and then we're going to write what the action is. For number one, the adverb is quietly. Of course, they've already given you the action, studied quietly. And what does quietly describe? Quietly describes how the action happens. For number two, the cart rolled downhill by itself. Rolled is the action. Downhill is the modifier. And of course, that's going to describe where the action happened. Number three, Kim coughs so loudly that it bothers me. Well, the coughing is the action as it's underlined, and loudly would describe, you got it, how it's happening. Number four, Helen paints well. Everyone says so. Painting is the action. Well is the description describing how she paints. So in the space for number four, you of course are going to write how that's happening. Excellent. And for number five, those two runners finished the race early. Finished is your action, early is your adverb, and early is describing, you got it, the time of day, when it happened. For number six, I thought you might come here for a change. The action is coming. Here is your adverb, and that describes, you got it, where. Could have said my house or the house, but here is where they are. Number seven, we went to a museum yesterday. The action is went. And the adverb describing when it happened, yesterday, it could have been last week or whatever, but it describes when it happened. Number eight, the maid arrived late. Arrived is your action, late is your adverb, and that describes, yep, you got it, when. Number nine, each student should work independently. That is the example given for the work we're doing currently. You're working independently, and that describes how you're working. Number 10, the stew cooks slowly on the stove. Cooked is your action, slowly. Notice that L-Y, L-Y, describing or indicating an adverb. And of course, the adverb slowly describes, you got it, how that action is happening. Number 11, Edna expressed herself beautifully. Expressed is your action, beautifully is your adverb. Notice the L-Y again. And beautifully is describing expressed as how it's being expressed, how. Number 12. I thought Kelly behaved rudely. Notice these LYs, all of them indicating an adverb, showing you where the adverb is. Rudely, right? And rudely describes, you got it, how that behavior is happening. Hopefully nobody is behaving rudely in class while you take the quiz. Number 13, I felt helpless as Mary cried unhappily. Another L-Y given away what that adverb is in the sentence. And the adverb for number 13 is describing how that action is happening. How is the crying happening? 14, the food arrived almost instantly. Another L-Y indicator showing you where that adverb is happening. And the adverb arrive is being, or instantly is describing when it arrived. 15, the boy peered cautiously around the corner. L-Y, adverb cautiously describing the action. How is it happening? How is he peering? Cautiously. Excellent. Your paper should look something like that for quiz 5A. Please make sure your name and the date is on your paper along with your cottage name. Please make sure the name and the date is on your paper. It could be loosely, or it could be worksheet 5A. Either way, the name and the date with your answers written clearly. We're going to move quickly now from worksheet 5A. Now that we have completed worksheet 5A, 1 through 15, we're going to begin worksheet. You should see worksheet 5B looks something like this here. Let us review the directions for worksheet 5B. Worksheet 5B, finding an adverb. Here, we're going to read each sentence, identify the words or word that is being used as an adverb, circle it, and some sentences may contain more than one adverb. So some may contain more than one adverb. Please circle the adverbs. Circle the adverbs. We're going to take 5 minutes for this quiz, 5 minutes. Beginning now, you should be circling the correct choice. Which of these is an adverb?
Take that home, get the sun.
And at last, it is done. Down to down, it's time to dig another one. A new limb, a new life, a new life time. Balance down the biggest way, race to us.
You may pause or stop the video at any time. We're going to take about another 30 seconds here. We're wrapping up worksheet 5B. Another 30 seconds or so, we're wrapping up worksheet 5B. Please make sure your name and the date and your cottage name is on your worksheet. If you're using loose leaf paper, you should have numbered your paper 1 to 6 and then written the correct adverbs. And let us take a look now. At worksheet 5B, hopefully you've completed your work. If you have not, please tell cottage staff that you need more time. We're going to quickly review worksheet 5B. All right, so let's get started now. Going through these quickly. Worksheet 5B, your answers. You were circling the correct adverbs. You should have had 6 adverbs written on your paper. 6 adverbs written on your paper. Starting with number 1. Reading the sentence. She sneezed mightily and with such force that it seemed the whole room shook. For number 1, mightily is your answer. Number 2, Kay gazed indifferently. By the way, you should always be looking for these words right here. Any word that ends in ly in these sentences is going to be an adverb. Keep that in mind. From the previous lessons, ly indicates an adverb. Number 2, Kay gazed indifferently at the math test on the desk in front of her. There you go. Indifferently is your adverb. Number 3, this is such a spectacular Lee, just like indifferently and mightily. Spectacularly simple cookie recipe. Well, that is awesome because it's an adverb. Number 4. The meal was delivered promptly 10 minutes after we ordered it. Now, there are two adverbs in this sentence, but one of them you should know quite easily because it's got that L-Y. And then another one describes when, how and when. So we have after, delivered promptly, and after, two of them. And for number five, I was completely disgusted by the service we ultimately received there. All right, looks like we got two adverbs here, right? Ultimately and completely. Number six, Kelly's imminent arrival clearly made us all nervous. And there's your L-Y adverb. All right, that is it for quiz 5B. Please make sure your name and the date is on your work and your cottage name. If you've written on loose leaf paper, it's important that you write clearly. That is it for 5B. Cottage staff, please make sure we're achieving all work and that their names are on their papers with their cottage names as well. That is it for adverbs and quizzes. Please make sure you turn in worksheet 5A and 5B and any other work that you have submitted during this week. And until next time, stay strong, stay proud, and be well. We appreciate your hard work. Please continue bringing them.